In November, you released your new EP, Going on Tour. Can you tell me about it?
In the process of we're recording a full length, and we're doing a tour with the Aquabats and Early Fish, and so we wanted to have something new out for the tour. So we ended up spawning the Going on Tour EP, which is a couple of songs that are going to be made for the full length, and yeah, we made it an EP.
The EP is only available for download on Amazon MP3 and iTunes, and then the physical copies in your online merch store. Why did you decide to pretty much only do a digital release?
Because we weren't going to have them available for that long, because we were going to be doing a full length, and we didn't want to spend money and actually put it together with an inlay and print it up when we weren't going to be selling very long. We just wanted something to have for the tour.
There are only 7 tracks on the EP. Were there songs that you wrote that you were going to put on the album or the EP that didn't make it?
Like I said, that we were recording a full length, and so we just took a couple of the songs from the full length and made the Going on Tour EP, because we have a full length album already recorded, or we're still recording it too. But it'll be done by next month.
Okay. Are all the 7 songs that were on the EP on the full length, or just some of them?
Just some of them.
Okay.
So some of the songs are exclusive to the EP.
Okay. And which song was your favorite on the EP, the record or write?
I think Open Up Your Eyes is just a great song. But I really like the song Asante, The Next Step. I wrote it a really long time ago, and it was nice to finally have it on an album.
Is there anything you can tell me about your full length that's coming out?
We're really stoked because it sounds a lot like our old stuff. It's kind of us going back to our old sound. We're just having a fun time writing it. You know, all the songs are funny. It just sounds like old Suburban Legends. That's what we think about it.
Do you have a title for it yet?
We had some time. We were toying around with titles, but now we don't. We don't have a name for it yet. So I think first things first, once it's done, then we'll make it.
Right, and fans should expect to see it in about a month.
Yeah, hopefully that's the plan. We're still recording it right now, but we're on the finishing touches of ending the recording process.
In February and March, you were overseas with Real Big Fish. How did that tour go?
It was awesome. We realized how much bigger our fan base has gotten in Europe since the last time we've been there. And we're actually going back there with Bowling for Soup in October.
And you have some shows around the OC over the next couple of weeks, and you did House of Blues a couple of days ago. Are there any besides the tour at Bowling for Soup, are there any other tour plans in the works for the rest of the summer?
Not for the summer, because we're focusing on finishing the album. And then we have some festivals, and we have some one-off shows around here that we're doing. Then we'll go to Europe, and then probably do a U.S. tour to support the album.
It's been a while since you've did like a full U.S. tour, hasn't it?
Yeah, I mean, we did the 2 tours with Aquabats and Ruby Fish in November and in January. But those are very long. Those are like 3.5 weeks, 4-week tours. So, yeah, hopefully we haven't done a proper U.S. tour in a long time, so it's about time.
If you could tour with anyone dead or alive or a broken up band, who would it be and why?
Wait, can you say that again?
If you could tour with anyone, who would it be and why?
I'm an obsessed Kiss fan. I would definitely be Kiss. I don't know, that's a good question. I would just want to do a tour with my favorite band, just because I get to watch it every night. So that'd be, I'd love be going to a Wu-Tang Clan.
Are there any final words you have for your fans?
Thanks for showing up.